Namaste. Today, Indian American community organized the Shradhanjali meeting to pay tributes to the two officers and also Delhi riot victims. Today, NRIs are very angry and also painful incident that happened in Delhi. What we can do from here. They were concerned about the distorted media and the propaganda that's been going on, especially in United States. New York Times, CNN, Wall Street Journal, they are distorting and then just blaming on one community that, they are the ones doing this. So there is no balanced reporting here. So we are, in our eyes, are focused on how to get it right, how to reach out to these, media outlets. Not only just that, but also reach out to politicians here to tell them the facts about what happened in Delhi and who orchestrated, who engineered these riots, and who are the victims. Thank you.
Jai Shri Ram, Namah Shivaya, Har Har Mahadev, Vande Mataram. देखिए आज हम सभी यहाँ इकट्ठा हुए हैं जो कुछ भी प्रीमेडिटेटिव तरीके से डेली रायट्स हुए हैं टेरर अटैक हुआ है दिल्ली वासियों पर एक सोची समझी योजना के तहत कई महीनों की तैयारी थी ये एक दिन की प्लानिंग नहीं थी ये तीन दिन की प्लानिंग नहीं थी ये देखिए विश्व के सबसे बड़े नेता जो हैं अपने ट्रंप उनका आदर सम्मान के साथ मोदी जी ने हमारे प्राइम मिनिस्टर ने आयोजन किया था दो दिवस का स्टैंड अलोन उनकी विजिट थी अहमदाबाद में दिल्ली से दूर ये सोचने की बात है आखिर क्यों मोदी जी ने दिल्ली से दूर कैपिटल से दूर ट्रंप का आगमन का को बुलाया और वहाँ जो रोड शो किया वहाँ जो उनका सत्कार हुआ इसके पीछे बहुत बड़ी सोच है क्योंकि मोदी जी दिल्ली में कुछ कर ही नहीं सकते दिल्ली को मुसलमानों ने इस्लामिक टेररिस्ट सोच के लोगों ने बंधक बना के रखा है आज हम सब इस विचार के खिलाफ खड़े हुए हैं पूरा विश्व खड़ा हुआ है और आप ये देखिए कि हमारे भारतीयों के लिए पूरे विश्व के भारतीयों के लिए जो एनआरआईज है उनके लिए उत्साह की बात थी कि ट्रंप वहाँ गए और दोनों देशों में एक जो समन्वय हुआ था वो न्यूज़ बिल्कुल दब गई है पूरी तरह पूरी वेस्टर्न मीडिया इंडिया की मीडिया और कुछ लोग रिपब्लिक मीडिया है और जी टीवी है सुदर्शन टीवी है कैपिटल टीवी है कुछ लोग हैं जो कि उसको कवर कर रहे हैं बाकी कोई भी कवर नहीं कर रहा है और ऐसी बायस्ड खबरें आ रही हैं कि खाली दूसरे धर्मों को मारा गया ऐसा नहीं है घरों से हमारी बच्चियों को छोटे बच्चों को उठाया गया उनके कपड़े मिले हैं उनकी लाशें मिली हैं जिंदा होते हुए उन्हें दो टुकड़ों में काटा गया है उनके हाथ पांव काटे गए हैं मुझे अंकित शर्मा जो हैं उनके शरीर पर 400 चाकुओं के निशान हैं उनकी आंतें बाहर आ गई उनके आंख को निकाला गया था मैं क्या बताऊं आपको ये और उसके बाद उनको गटर में नाले में फेंक दिया था ऐसी कई लाशें वहां से निकली हैं मैं आपको क्या ये बर्बरता है ये नरपिशाच हैवानियत है इसके पीछे कौन है ये लोग क्या है? हम तो ऐसे लोग हैं जो देवभव शांति अंतरिक्ष शांति विश्व सभी की शांति की बात करते हैं हम पत्थरों को पूछते हैं जानवरों को पूछते हैं इंसान को पूछते हैं वातावरण को पूछते हैं पंचदेवों को पूछते हैं पंचभूत को पूछते हैं अपने में शरीर में बैठे हुए आपके शरीर में बैठे हुए आत्मा को हम पूछने वालों में से हैं पर हमें इस तरह से उकसाया जा रहा है हमें इस बात पे मजबूर किया जा रहा है कि हम जो धार्मिक है जो मेडिटेशन करने वाले हैं पूजा पाठ करने वाले हैं रुद्राभिषेक करने वाले हैं जो हवन पाठ करने वाले लोग हैं, हमें अब सड़क पे उतर के कहना पड़ रहा है कि बंद करो, enough is enough, enough is enough. We will take action. If you are going to stand and terrorize our people, common people, बिचारा जो वो गाड़ी लेके जा रहा है, हाँ, अपने बच्चों को 10 दिहाड़ी में जी रहा है, उसकी ने क्या गलती की है? जय सियाराम, वंदे.
Premeditative way of creating mayhem, disrupting common people's life, and it is being done by the political parties. What is happening? The points are the people who are instigating such riots. They are associated with, and I'm going to say it, not just one party, the major parties, major political parties are involved in that. So how come when they were elected and the due diligence was done by those political parties, be it Tahir Hussein, be it, there are many, many other ones, when the due diligence was done and they were allotted to run for a political premeditative way of creating mayhem, disrupting common people's life, and it is being done by the political parties. What is happening? The points are the people who are instigating such riots, they are associated with, and I'm going to say it, not just one party, the major parties, major political parties are involved in that. So how come when they were elected and the due diligence was done by those political parties, be it Tahir Hussein, be it, there are many, many other ones, when the due diligence was done and they were allotted to run for a political...
Yes, Shyaram, Namaskar. We all are gathered here to pay our condolences to our brave soldier who had lost their life because of the jihadi terrorism which is going on on the streets of New Delhi. हमने देखा है कि ये जिहादी टेररिज्म ने पूरा वर्ल्ड को अपने अंदर ले लिया है, चाहे वो सीरिया हो, चाहे चेचनिया हो, चाहे सिंध प्रोविंस हो पाकिस्तान का, चाहे बलूचिस्तान हो, चाहे हमारा कश्मीर हो, चाहे पाकिस्तान ऑक्युपाइड कश्मीर हो, चाहे ट्विन टावर्स हो, चाहे लंदन की सड़कें हो, चाहे पेरिस का एफिल टावर हो, चाहे श्रीलंका हो, चाहे न्यूजीलैंड हो, चाहे ऑस्ट्रेलिया हो, हर जगह ये जिहादी टेररिज्म फैल रहा है. नाउ इट इज स्प्रेडिंग लाइक अ कैंसर, इट्स स्प्रेडिंग मच फास्टर देन अ कैंसर स्प्रेड इन द ह्यूमन बॉडी. सो नाउ इज अ टाइम वी हैव टू स्टैंड अप, वी हैव टू स्टैंड अप एज द वर्ल्ड हैज टू स्टैंड अप एंड से इनफ इज इनफ, वी कांट टॉलरेट ऑल दोस टेररिस्ट एक्टिविटी एनी मोर इन द वर्ल्ड. अब हमें खड़े हो जाना चाहिए. इन्होंने कभी क्रिश्चियंस को मारते हैं, कभी हिंदुओं को मारते हैं, कभी ये बौद्धों को मारते हैं, और अपने अपने आप को ये विक्टिम डिक्लेयर करते हैं. जो वर्ल्ड ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस हैं वो भी इनके ऊपर बहुत लिबरली एक्शन नहीं लेती है. नाउ इज़ द टाइम टू कम अप एंड वी हैव टू टेक द स्टैंड. द यूएन हैज़ टू कम एंड से दैट रॉन्ग इज़ रॉन्ग एंड राइट इज़ राइट. अदरवाइज the day is not far off when we have another main genocide coming any other part of the world. Thank you.
Today we gathered here at Umia Temple to pay Shradhanjali and homage to the fallen soldiers, policemen, as well as people of the Delhi riot victims. OF BJP President Krishna Reddy ji, Rajya Lakshmi ji and many others were the prominent speakers at this event. We basically did the fundraising also. And it is our appeal to the like-minded people of the Indian origin to please stand united and to fight against the jihad and to also respond and rebuttal the negative narrative. CAA kiski citizenship leta nahi hai, CAA saro ko citizenship deta hai. Those persecuted minorities, India gives them a shelter, India gives them a board, from Afghanistan, Pakistan, and Bangladesh, which is basically a Muslim country, and the non-Muslims there are getting, you know, prosecuted, and India gives them a shelter. So please show the solidarity, and thank you for this opportunity.
Bharat. बेटी ने दूसरों के ऊपर अत्याचार किया, उनके ऊपर भेजा, फेंका इन सब चीजों को. पर अगर देखा जाए, तो सारी communities इसमें affect हुई हैं. और common people, their shops were burnt. एक बिचारा जो ठेला लगा के he runs a cart and he earns his living. What crime did he commit that his cart was burnt? And these people coming from UP, Madhya Pradesh, Bihar, Punjab, Haryana, poor people, they are leaving Delhi. Is it a premeditative way of making sure that certain people do not live in Delhi? Something that we need to think about. Plus, I know there are many, many speakers who are here. They will expand on these things. The narrative, the media coverage is one-sided. Wall Street Journal, out of all people, Wall Street Journal, New York Times, these media coverage is one-sided and biased. Wall Street Journal writes in the paper that he spoke to Ankit Mishraji's brother, and he was told by Ankit Mishraji's brother, by the way, that family has left. I mean, beyond imagination, 400 knife wounds that poor little boy suffered. For me, he's a little boy. That family has left New Delhi.
Very sad.
Very sad. It is, I mean, I can't even express my words. Now, Wall Street Journal writes that Jai Shri Ram, the mob that was chanting Jai Shri Ram, captured Ankit Mishra and killed him. Whereas it's totally different story. He did not speak to Ankit Mishra's brother, said no one from Wall Street Journal spoke to him. So there is an FIR against Wall Street Journal too. Barkha Dutt writes, so I can go on and on. We have only 2 hours and 4 o'clock. So next in agenda, we need to stand up and be silent for one minute. Please stand up for all those people who have left their life.
నమస్తే. ఈరోజు ఇండియన్ అమెరికన్ కమ్యూనిటీ ఇక్కడ శ్రద్ధాంజలి మీటింగ్ ఎడిసన్ న్యూజెర్సీలో జరిపింది. అయితే ఢిల్లీ రైట్ విక్టమ్స్ ఈ 2 ఆఫీసర్సే కాకుండా ఇంకా చాలామంది చనిపోయినారు కాబట్టి వాటి గురించి ఈ సంతాప సభ జరిగింది. అయితే ఈ సంతాప సభలో ఎలా జరిగిపోయింది, ఇది దీన్ని ఎవరు ఇంజనీర్ చేసారు రైట్స్ని, ప్లస్ అదే కాకుండా మీడియా దీన్ని ఎట్లా డిస్టార్ట్ చేస్తుంది న్యూస్ని, ఎస్పెషలీ హియర్ ఇన్ యునైటెడ్ స్టేట్స్ అనే దాని గురించి మాట్లాడడం జరిగింది. అయితే ఎన్ఆర్ఐస్ అంతా కలిసి దే డిటర్మిన్ టు రీచ్ అవుట్ టు దీస్ మీడియా అవుట్లెట్స్, మేబీ సిఎన్ఎన్ఏ కానివ్వండి, న్యూయార్క్ టైమ్సే కానివ్వండి, వాల్ స్ట్రీట్ జర్నలే కానివ్వండి, వాషింగ్టన్ పోస్టే కానివ్వండి. అదే కాకుండా ఈ పొలిటీషియన్స్ ఎవరైతే ఉన్నారో ఈ ఫ్యాక్ట్స్ తెలియకుండా ట్వీట్ చేసేస్తున్నారు ఇమీడియట్గా. సో వాళ్ళని కూడా రీచ్ అవుట్ అయ్యి మనము ఈ ఫ్యాక్ట్స్ వాళ్ళకు చెప్పాలని కూడా నిర్ణయించడం జరిగింది.
చర్యను ఖండిస్తూ ఎవరైతే ఈ అల్లర్లకు పాల్పడ్డారో వారికి ఇమీడియట్గా శిక్ష వేయాలని కోరుకుంటూ భారత్ మాతాకి జై, వారందరికీ మా తరఫున శ్రద్ధాంజలి.
We all have seen the family picture of the 40-year-old Ratan Lal, his wife and his 3 beautiful children who don't have a father now. And we have seen this 26-year intelligence officer Ankit Sharma stabbed 400 times by 6 people, and somebody already talked about it. And I don't know how many people have seen this. Times of India reported this, that just one market alone, the loss is 40 to 60 crores worth destroyed. And the overall loss can be anywhere from 1500 to 2000 crores. It's an enormous amount of financial loss to the country as well, to destruction of people's lives. This we all have seen, brutality unleashed. And I want to come to this part, which I think Krishna Reddy ji spoke, and in my article I'm going to talk a lot of the, I see it in WhatsApp groups, and we are all talking about the radical Islam and Hindus and the fight between. But we should not lose sight about what the Western institutions, especially the media and others, are doing to fuel this fire. If you want to understand what is going on with the Western media, you have to go back to, for example, Will Durant book on Case for India. This man is an American historian. This is a big monumental book on history of civilizations he wrote for over we and his wife for 40, 50 years. It's a beautiful, beautiful volume, monument of work, and which I have read. And while he was writing the book, he found out he didn't have much interest. He's of course studying all the civilizations on the world. And he came, when, as he was reading about the Indian civilization, the Hindu civilization, he was surprised that there is such a great civilization, such an advancement to people. And then he wanted to, when he looked about the grand temples, he wanted to come to India and see for himself in 1930. He visited India. He's an American. And he wanted to visit India, and he visited 1930 and completely surprised. I mean, heartbroken. It was heart-wrenching to him. What is the great civilization I have been studying about? What is the state of this civilization I'm seeing today before my eyes? And he poured his heart. I have posted on the WhatsApp. You can, it's free, freely available, Case for India. Read that first chapter. You would not even imagine what he has written, the state of India. He said the only difference between between Louisiana slaves and the Hindus, he did not even say Indians. He said Hindus in India under British is the lynching, except that everything is as bad as it was the slavery, because they were attached to death beyond imagination. The economic thing, I mean, the plunder they have done to destroy Hindus and the famines, and he could not take it. But one thing he also noted in that book is, in all the principalities ruled by the East India Company and of course later British at the time, is the Hindu-Muslim riots is the most common thing. And in all the places where the Mysore and those native principalities where native rulers, Hindu rulers are ruling, the Hindu-Muslim riots are almost unheard of. And he's telling how this British has used, there are problems in Hindus and Muslims, and there are civilizational, historic issues. But how the British have fueled it and used it for their purposes. But I want to fast forward to what is happening today. Today what is happening, you can see how, just yesterday Gopi Krishna tweeted that a media person came to him and asked him, he will pay $2,500 for writing an article on religion basis. He was telling how when the 2G scam was given, crores for rupees were given. And there we have seen people, how this Western media is asking the Indian, bribing them to write articles to divide and make Hindus as the perpetrators and Muslims as victims. And how they camouflage thing and how they blatantly lied about it. So the picture we need to understand is, this is not something they are doing to India. East India Company has done in other countries. And there is a three force that is happening, that is taking advantage of the situation. One is the most important thing is the Christian missionary complex. Christian missionary complex in US and the West, they have declared the 1040 latitude of the world to be the place where they want to convert. 1040 latitude, if you look at it, the most of it is India. They have converted Africa within one century from anywhere from 5% to 40%. Now they want to convert Asia, and India is the place where you have 1.4 billion people, and it is also very vulnerable because of the democracy. And then that is one thing. Then there is the business establishment. When I say West, it's not just US, it's Europe and the Western establishment. They want to use India for the labor, they want to use it for market, they want to use it for technical coolies, but they want also, most importantly, they're concerned about the rise of China, and they need somebody to counter the, because China is exerting itself in Asia and all, and they want to use, they want to take India as a prop, India as against China. So they don't want India to be completely be destroyed, but at the same time, they do not want to be another threat to Western global dominance. You understand what's going on? Now, this Western establishment and the missionary complex and the Western agencies work in hand so that they accomplish this goal. To understand what is happening, how they divided Rwanda, if you go and see Rwanda, how it is done, how they set one tribe against another. If you go back in Aztecs in Mexican population or in Africa, one tribe against another. This is the same agenda these people are using to purposely and deliberately show Muslims as victims, because Muslims are easier to use as a weapon, and they can use them to control and contain India. We should not lose this perspective, what is happening around. And they are providing a cover for Hindus to be butchered and the Muslims to be raised up. And this is why, and there is a grand thing. Have you ever seen a Magsaysay award who is pro-Hindu? Did you know that Nobel Prize was not given Mahatma Gandhi because he's against the Christian missionary activities in India? Of all the Hindus in India and all the foolish things Mahatma Gandhi did with Islamic appeasement, he is also a most vocal person about Christian missionary agenda. This imperialistic agenda is no less than the Islamic agenda. We need to understand that point, and we have to call the spade a spade. And they are fueling it. They are providing cover for the Muslims, and they are raising it. They are literally fueling this thing and raising it. We have to understand this. Also, Hindus and India is used as a cover for the activities they are doing in the Middle East. At the same time, Gujarat riots happened. They were butchering the Middle East. I mean, we are from this country, we have to call the spade a spade, and I have a First Amendment right as a citizen of this country to speak for what is happening. So at the same time they're butchering the Iraqi Muslims, they want to show that the same media which is supporting them, they want to show that that they also love Muslims. Muslim love, you hear this thing, is a cover. What you see, they have only Muslim loves for the Buddhists in Myanmar or Hindus in India. They don't have Muslim laws. Who created ISIS? In the presidential debate, I think Trump I think raised, we created ISIS. And who did the ISIS destroy? They didn't destroy any Christians, or maybe a few Christians then. But the most they destroyed is Muslims. So the Middle East destruction, the taking, the grabbing of the oil wealth, they are using destroying it, and they are using it to have a threat for Israel, whatever other agendas they have. But they are using us, our country and our Hindus, as a slaughter, as they are showing them, oh, we love Muslims, while camouflaging the activities what they are doing in Middle Eastern countries. In fact, this, Clinton's Madeleine Albright in a Fox interview, she said, she was asked, did you have any regrets that Clinton era sanctions killed 250,000 Iraqi Muslim children because they didn't have emergency medicines, the vital medicines they need? And she said, I don't have a regret for it. And these people are going to teach us?
This media, this New York Times, this Washington Post is going to tell us we Hindus are perpetrators and Muslims are loving? No. They have an agenda, and we need to speak about this agenda. We have every right as a First Amendment right to speak up for this agenda. They want to use these divisions just like they did in Rwanda, just like they did in South America, just like did the tribals of Africa. They want to convert, control, and contain India. That agenda needs to be understood really well before we can make address the problem, this problem we are having. So I mean, I have written so please, you all know, many of you know, to the funding, I just gave the websites you can give to the 501c3. Without 501c3, you can give to Crowd Cash. If you want 501c3, you can give to Aroveda. But they already raised about 68 lakhs. Even if we raise 1 crore, it is minimal. The government help is very important. But we request all of you to support this activity, but understand the problem, and we had addressed it multiple ways. We had addressed the Muslim way, addressing Islamic fundamentalism, but we should also understand Western fundamentalism, which is as dangerous as the Islamic fundamentalism. Thank you.
Now I'd like to invite
Yadam Om Swastina Indro Vridashabaha Swastina Pukha Vishwavedaha Swastina Sto Arishtani Swastino Brihaspatir Dadhatu Om Purnamidam Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Harihi Om Om. Om Namaste Stu Bhagavan Vishveshwaraya Mahadevaya Trayambakaya Tripuramtakaya Trikaladni Kalaya Kaladni Rudraya Neelakantaya Mrityunjayaya Sarveshwaraya Sadashivaya Shriman Mahadevaya Namaha. Om Trayambakam Yajamahe Sugandhin Pushtivardhanam Uravarukameva Bandhanan Mrityor Mukshiya Mamritat Hari Om. Now we're going to recite the Shanti Mantra. If you know it, please recite with us. Om Dyao Shanti Antariksha Gum Shanti Prithavi Shanti Rapaha Shanti Oshadayaha Shanti Vanaspatayaha Shanti Vishwe Deva Shanti Brahma Shanti Sarvagum Shanti Shanti Reva Shanti Sama Shanti Revi Om Shanti 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 Hari Om. Now I'd like everyone to make a line. There are flowers over there. Take it. And please offer it to, there are more than these two people. There are more than 44 people who have lost their life. Families have lost their belongings. Families, their homes, their shops have been burned. But this is just symbolic. And while you are offering flowers, we will just recite Gayatri Mantra. Okay, so
let's go on. And I'm a Kashmiri Pandit. I'm an author of several books, one of which I'll read some passages out for you. And I'm also co-founder of Global Kashmiri Pandit Diaspora, which is active on the subject of Kashmiri Pandit genocide. There are three key lessons or takeaways that I want to share with you in terms of learnings, so that we can, to use an old proverb, to be forewarned is to be forearmed. So the first thing I want to talk about, which Rajalakshmiji talked about, is the ghastly episode that occurred with the young intelligence officer. Now, you have to understand the significance of what happened. And the best way for me to explain the significance is to read out to you about what happened in Kashmir in 1400 AD. At that time, the last ruler of Kashmir was a woman. She was a Hindu woman. Her name was Kota Rani. And she was succeeded by Shamir. And Shamir was the Tahir of his time. And he faked that he was ill. And Kota Rani was concerned, and she sent Brahma, who you could think of as the intelligence officer of her time, accompanied by Captain Avatar. And Captain Avatar you could think about as Ratanlal. So you will see that there are remarkable similarities in the story. Brahma, it is good that you came, Shamir said in a hoarse voice. The Maharani is a good woman, even if we have had our differences. Come closer and lift me up so that I can rest against the headboard and look at you as I talk to you. Brahma went up to the other side of the bed. He and Avatar gently lifted Shamir up, but as they did so, the fakir suddenly tossed Avatar's sword into his hands. Shamir took the sword and thrust it first into Brahma's chest. Avatar tried to save Brahma with his bare hands, but the fakir clasped them from behind. Shamir rose from the bed like a coiled cobra and plunged the already bloody sword inside Avatar. Now I will quote to you what Jona Raja, the historian in the 14th century, wrote in the Raj Tarangani about this episode. He buried their own weapon in their own bodies and thus allayed the illness of his mind. So Jona Raja is signaling these are very mentally ill people. Blood issued from their heads and water came out of their eyes. Their lives left their bodies, and the rancor that Shamir had felt left his mind. Shamir was bathed in their blood. As one bathes after recovery from an illness, the two heads were like the two halves of a vessel, and their wounds were like the marks of a lamp. This is what the historian Jona Raja wrote. Jamaat, the fakir shouted out loudly. The people who were hanging outside the door rushed in, led by Sheikh. When they saw the two dying men bleeding on the floor, they started hacking at them with their swords. They were like hyenas ripping pieces off their prey. While the fakir and Shamir watched them smiling, Sheikh, Puj and Ali, along with their cohorts, picked up the mangled bodies, carried them outside, and threw them in front of the shocked attendants who had accompanied Brahma and Avatar on their mission of mercy. The terrorized attendants were made to load the bodies on horseback amid the jeers of Shamir's followers and rushed back to the Maharani. So the bodies are carried back to the court.
Go back a little bit.
The bodies are carried back to the court, and there is a big discussion, as is true of the discussions that are happening within the Indian community all over the world. And there also, there were people trying to defend the indefensible. But in that case, the Minister of Justice walked over to the corpses. He stood in front of Sharaka. Sharaka is the wife of Brahma. So that she was shielded from the bodies, he didn't want her to see it. And he ripped one of the white covers away. A gasp went through the assembled crowd. The bodies had been mutilated beyond measure. The eyes had been gouged out. hollow hole stared out of the half skull that was cut with deep gashes. Their scrotums had been ripped. Every inch of their chest had been stabbed. Something familiar? Every inch of their chest had been stabbed. But what was truly ghoulish was that there were bite marks on the bodies. The minister hastily put the white cover back on the bodies. Has anything changed in the formula in the last 700 years? No. So why so? And now I go to the second lesson of Kashmir. There's a great text written in Kashmir called Natya Shastra by Bharata. Natya Shastra is the foundation of our dance. Bharatanatyam is named after that. It is the foundation of our poetry. It's the foundation of our music and our arts. And in Natya Shastra, we for the first time hear about rasa theory. And in rasa theory, there is the rasa of horror, the rasa of terror. And Bharata says, the bhayanak rasa, the rasa of terror and horror, is designed to create a certain reaction in you. And he says, this reaction is, you either freeze or you run away. There is no idea of fight and flight. No. Bharata says, you either freeze or you run away. And now, lesson number three from Kashmir that you are beginning to see as we speak in India. The 700-year lesson of Kashmir, which we till this day have not understood, is that violence has paid these people very handsomely. Violence against India has paid them inordinately. People are shocked when I say to them that the genocide of Kashmiri Pandits in 1990 resulted in a windfall benefit, genocide transfer of assets that could be as high as $35 billion in today's day. So this is violence that is directed towards transfer of your assets to them. They feed on it. And you're already seeing evidence of it. You will see Sajjana people like you living in these colonies saying, "Is mahol mein kohan rahega?" The flight process started. You see in Agra where there are echo protests going on today. Articles coming out, people are saying, ye ghar hum bech rahe hain. Slowly, slowly, they are establishing no-go zones. All right, these are the three lessons. Formula has not changed. Formula is based on bhayanak, terror and horror, and formula is based on transferring your wealth into their hands. Zan, Zameen, Zanana. Three things. They want your women, they want your land, they want your gold. The three Z's. Okay, now the way forward. The way forward is very simple. Nobody ever in our texts has said, when you are faced with this situation, that you should raise money for charity. Nobody has ever said that. What we have been told explicitly is when there is a dharma, each one of you has to become an avatar. That's what you have been told. You have to become an avatar. That is the responsibility you have to face a dharma. So what is the practical suggestion for this particular situation? As a student of Kashmir, I am trained to analyze these situations. And let me tell you, where do you think these people allocated their resources of savagery and destruction? Where do you think they focused it? Their maximum resources were not in killing people, horrible as it was. Their maximum resources were not in stone throwing, horrible as it was. Their maximum resources were not in throwing acids or shooting bullets, no. They sent several hundred people to completely destroy a school that was there.
Absolutely.
Think about it. Why would they send several hundred people when there is mischief and murder and loot? They could have gone and looted, but no. The shock troops went. There was a school there for 1,000 kids, and they destroyed everything in that empty school. Why do you think they did that? They did that because they know we care. Our pathway is the pathway of Saraswati, of knowledge. They knew by destroying the future of 1,000 children, they are destroying 1,000 lives.
Disgusting.
And so as avatars, I would respectfully submit to you. If China can build a 2,200 patient hospital in a week, if you are avatars and you have links in India, send a message. We want that school built in one week. We want to be in their face that our way of life will triumph, because our way of life is a life that progresses, that builds the future. We represent that, because what are we told? What does our prayer tell us? Lead those who have died into immortality, and lead us from darkness into light. Thank you.
Beautifully said, and he carries the agony of Kashmiri Pandit as well as each and every Sanatani all over the world with him in his heart. I'd like to invite Jyotsnaji to say a few words. She's very passionate in her beliefs, as well as her father,
was ex-serviceman, as well as he was a police officer, as well as an ex-serviceman.
There you go. So she carries the pain as well. So we are going to hear from her now.
नहीं, that's fine. नमस्कार, मैं दिल्ली से हूँ और मेरे पिताजी एक सर्विसमैन थे, एयरफोर्स में थे और उसके बाद उन्होंने दिल्ली पुलिस ज्वाइन की. और जहाँ तक दिल्ली में सौहार्द का माहौल रहता है और या फिर जो भी बुरी चीज़ें हुई हैं उन्हें बहुत करीबी से देखा है. दिल्ली पुलिस के हाथ क्यों बंधे हुए थे वो भी बताऊँगी और दिल्ली में क्या होता है वो भी बताऊंगी. बड़ा लाइव अकाउंट है. अभी जो हाल ही में दंगे हुए हैं, मेरे सबसे बड़े भाई ने शायद बहुत ही करीबी तरीके से देखा, क्योंकि वो उन्हीं तीन इलाकों में थे. मैं नाम नहीं लूंगी पब्लिकली, बट मौजपुर, ब्रह्मपुरी, शिवपुरी या जाफराबाद, उन्हीं कहीं इलाकों के बीच में वो भी रह रहे थे अपने बच्चों के साथ. चलिए थोड़ा पीछे जाते हैं. पहले 1984 के रायट्स की बात करते हैं, जहां सिखों का नरसंहार हुआ था. मैं उस कॉलोनी से हूं जहां पर इंदिरा गांधी के जो मर्डरर थे बेअंत सिंह, वो रहा करते थे. पहले वो पुलिस में थे, ऑफ कोर्स उनके सर्विस पीएसओ थे. और जिस दिन वो हरकत हुई थी, जब इंदिरा गांधी को मार दिया गया था, हम बहुत छोटे थे, मैं बहुत छोटी थी, 5 या 6 साल उम्र होगी मेरी. पूरी की पूरी कॉलोनी हमारी छावनी में तब्दील हो गई थी. और उसके बाद जो नंगा नाच हुआ दिल्ली में, जहां जहां सिख पाए उन सबको मार दिया गया, काट दिया गया, जला दिया गया. वो शायद उन पुलिस वालों ने भी देखा जो पुलिस वाले खुद भी सिख थे। आप मानेंगे नहीं, दिल्ली पुलिस के वो नौजवान जो सिख ऑफिसर्स थे उन्होंने अपने बाल कटवा दिए थे ताकि उन्हें मॉब लिंचिंग में शहीद ना होना पड़े। पूरे पूरे सिख खालसा पंथ के लोग, पूरे पूरे परिवार के लोगों ने पूरे मौला बाल करवा लिए थे, पूरे कटवा लिए थे। नेक्स्ट डोर नेबर थे, बहुत सारे नेबर्स थे और बहुत सारे नेबर्स ऐसे भी थे जो कि घायल हुए थे इन्हीं चीजों में। जब दिल्ली में नफरत की आग फैलती है, जहर फैलता है तो बहुत लंबा जाता है। दिल्ली इज द कैपिटल सिटी ऑफ इंडिया। इस कैपिटल से जो मैसेज जाता है बहुत तगड़ा है और शायद वो चीज याद थी अब तक 1984 की बातें। पिताजी मेरे दिल्ली पुलिस में थे, राजौरी गार्डन क्षेत्र के डिवीजन ऑफिसर हुआ करते थे उस समय, और जिस बुरे हाल में वो चार चार पांच दिन तक घर नहीं आते थे वो भी याद है। और शायद हम अपने पिताजी को शायद एक एक महीने भी देखा नहीं हमने उन्हें, कि मम्मी घर आए थे पिताजी या नहीं आए थे पता नहीं है, क्योंकि जल्दी चले आते थे और रात को देर आते थे या फिर आते ही नहीं थे। अब बात करते हैं दिल्ली पुलिस की, जो दिल्ली पुलिस को बहुत गालियां पड़ रही हैं कि दिल्ली पुलिस ने एक्ट नहीं किया, शाहीन बाग हो गया, ये सब चीजें हो गई। तो सबसे पहले ये बताइए, जब शाहीन बाग में पहले दिन प्रोटेस्ट हुआ था जामिया में, तब जब दिल्ली पुलिस के लोगों ने डंडों से पिटाई करनी शुरू की उन नास्टी स्टूडेंट्स की, उन टेररिस्ट की जो कि इन स्टूडेंट्स के वेश में मिलकर के साथ में दंगा करने भेजे गए थे खास तौर से, तब उनके खिलाफ विद्रोह क्यों हुआ? क्यों बोला गया दिल्ली पुलिस ने हमारे ऊपर अत्याचार किया? जामिया की लाइब्रेरी के वीडियोस देखिए, छात्रों के हाथ में वो पत्थर थे, ईंटें थी, गंदे गंदे नारे लगाते हुए जा रहे थे और नारे तो पहले से लग रहे थे। पुलिस वाला जो होता है ना, एक इंसान होता है, उसका भी परिवार है, उसके भी बच्चे हैं जो कि पढ़ते हैं, जो कि उम्मीद करते हैं मेरे पापा मेरे घर आएंगे वापस और जो है मेरी जीवन की दिनचर्या चलती रहेगी, मुझे कमा के मेरी फीस देते रहेंगे स्कूल की। दिल्ली पुलिस के जो जवान है उनकी कोई बहुत बड़ी सैलरी नहीं होती है। दिल्ली पुलिस को बदनाम किया जाता है, पुलिस वालों को जनरली बदनाम किया जाता है करप्शन के नाम से, लेकिन शायद लोग भूल जाते हैं वो इंसान है जिनको बहुत कम सैलरीज दी जाती है, उनकी मेहनत के एवज में बहुत कम पेमेंट मिलती है। वही दिल्ली पुलिस के जवान जब वायलेंट हो गए या पुलिस जो कंट्रोल करना चाह रही थी वायलेंट मॉब को, उस समय उनके खिलाफ जो है पूरी की पूरी मीडिया, ह्यूमन राइट्स कमीशन, तो सारी दुनिया भर की चीजें आ जाती हैं। दिल्ली पुलिस सेंट्रली गवर्नमेंट, सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट के अंदर आती है, स्टेट गवर्नमेंट के अंदर नहीं आती, आपके नॉलेज के लिए भी बता दें। बट सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट का रोल क्या चल रहा था? हालात कुछ ऐसे थे कि हमारे देश में अमेरिका के प्रेसिडेंट का दौरा होना था, हालात ये भी था कि दिल्ली में इलेक्शन होने वाले थे, और कहीं ना कहीं दिल्ली पुलिस को रिस्ट्रेंट करा जाता है बोल करके कि भाई कोई वायलेंट एक्ट ना हो, शांति से उन्हें वहीं बैठे रहने देना शाहीन बाग के लोगों को, ताकि ये हिंदू मुस्लिम दंगा ना फैल जाए। आम आदमी पार्टी के नेता, शीर्ष नेता अरविंद केजरीवाल जी ने जो गंदगी मचाई उसके बारे में भी बोलूंगी, क्योंकि दिल्ली से हूं, घर वाले बहुत सारे लोग, कॉलोनी के कुछ लोग एपी को सपोर्ट करते हैं तो बीजेपी की बहुत सपोर्ट करते हैं और भी हैं। क्या बोला था उन्होंने? जब शाहीन बाग में गंद मच रही थी, जामिया में वायलेंस हो चुका था, अमानतुल्ला खान ने जब उस वायलेंस को हाक दे दी थी, उसके बावजूद अरविंद केजरीवाल जी का कहना था कि मैं जामिया के लोगों के साथ हूं, मनीष सिसोदिया का कहना था मैं जामिया के लोगों के साथ हूं, यह भी नहीं, यह भी उनका कहना था कि हम सीएए के खिलाफ हैं। तो सीएए के खिलाफ अगर आप हैं तो आपने एक पक्की एंडोर्समेंट दे दी उन सभी लोगों को, सभी मुसलमान भाइयों को, कि सीएए तो बहुत जहरीली चीज है जो आपके तन और मन का चैन छीन लेगी। जब एक नेता ऐसी बात करता है तो अंधेर गर्दी मच जाती है। वही किया अरविंद केजरीवाल ने, क्योंकि उन्हें मुस्लिम वोट चाहिए थे। मेरे खास एक पड़ोसन है जो काफी एडवोकेसी करती है आम आदमी पार्टी के लोगों के लिए और करती रही, उनकी फेसबुक वॉल जाके देखिए, हमारे मुस्लिम भाई जिस तरह से बड़े गुणगान गाते हैं अरविंद केजरीवाल के, और उसके बाद जितनी नफरत की बातें उनकी पर्सनल फेसबुक पेजों पे हैं, जहां वो हिंदुस्तान के खिलाफ, हिंदू के खिलाफ, हिंदुत्व के खिलाफ, उनकी मौत के खिलाफ गाना गाते हैं, वो नजर आएगा आपको। यह अंधेरा मंजर हमारे देश में अरविंद केजरीवाल जी ने, जो आम आदमी पार्टी के शीर्ष नेता है, गंदगी मचा करके किया। और उसके बाद उन्होंने ये कह दिया कि मेरा कोई रोल नहीं है शाहीन बाग के लोगों को, मैं उठा नहीं सकता, क्योंकि वो तो सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट और दिल्ली पुलिस देखेगी। लेकिन अगर आप नेता हैं तो आपको चाहिए था कि आप उस भीड़ को हटाते, आप मैसेज देते कि आप शांतिप्रिय घर से रूप से घर जाइए और हम इसका जो है बातचीत करके सरकार से सोल्यूशन करेंगे। तो दिल्ली में गंदगी मचाने के लिए जहां कौमी बंटवारा किया गया, वहां आम आदमी पार्टी जैसी क्या कहते हैं इस एजेंसीज ने, और मैं कहूंगी टेररिस्ट लाइक एजेंसी बन गई जब आम आदमी पार्टी, क्योंकि उन्होंने अमानतुल्ला खान को टिकट दी इलेक्शन में, और वही वो एमएलए है जिसने 70,000 वोट से इलेक्शन जीता। जहां दिल्ली में विकास के नाम पर ये इलेक्शन लड़ा जा रहा था और बोला जा रहा था कि स्कूलों में बड़ा विकास हुआ है, वही प्रतिनिधि मनीष सिसोदिया जो एजुकेशन मिनिस्टर थे उनके नाम पे उनको सिर्फ मात्र 3,000 वोटों से जीत मिली। बताइए आतंकवाद की जीत थी या फिर शिक्षा की या ग्रोथ की? ये हमें नजर आया अमानतुल्ला खान को जिस दिन टिकट मिल गई थी उसी दिन हमें नजर आ रहा था दिल्ली अंधेरे की तरफ जा रही है। यही हुआ है दिल्ली में, अमानतुल्ला खान जैसे बहुत सारे खान बैठे हैं जो बांटना शुरू कर रहे हैं देश को। तारिक हुसैन हो कोई और हो, ये सब वो लोग हैं जिनको पीछे से तगड़ी सपोर्ट है। कांग्रेस पार्टी ने भी बड़े अंधेर गर्दी के हिसाब से पूरी बैक सपोर्ट दी है, बैकफुट पे रह करके कोवर्ट तरीके से हमारे देश के लोगों में जो है नफरत फैलाई है और आम आदमी पार्टी को पूरा सपोर्ट किया, क्योंकि कांग्रेस खुल करके इलेक्शन में आई ही नहीं। इस बार दिल्ली में हमने लाइव देखा है, हम दिल्ली के लोग हैं इसलिए ध्यान से जानते हैं जनता। जनता को बेवकूफ बनाया गया है। दिल्ली में डीटीसी पे 17,500 करोड़ का घाटा है और उसके बावजूद वुमेन को फ्री टिकट दी जा रही है, उसके बावजूद बिजली पानी फ्री किया गया मात्र लास्ट के 3 महीनों में, पहले नहीं किया गया। ये जो फ्री का खेल था अरविंद केजरीवाल को बहुत महंगा पड़ेगा। इस बार तो जीत गए, अगली बार शायद
इवन पास इवेंट्स एंड पास सच रायस इफ यू सी इट हैज बीन प्लान्ड वेरी सिस्टमैटिकली। सो फर्स्ट दे स्टार्ट विद अ वेरी सो कॉल्ड साइलेंट प्रोटेस्ट। द सो कॉल्ड साइलेंट प्रोटेस्ट इज डन फॉर समथिंग दैट इज नॉट इवन देयर, द इश्यू डजंट एग्जिस्ट। दे क्रिएट इमेजिनरी इश्यू, दे क्रिएट अ फॉल्स नरेटिव अराउंड इमेजिनरी इश्यू and then they protest. So those who are actually talking about CAA and those who are orchestrating these riots very well know that CAA has nothing to do taking away anybody's citizenship in India. They very well know that the CAA is only for those who have been tortured, who have been persecuted in the other countries, and they were promised by successive governments starting from the independence to have them citizenships in India if they are persecuted. But using such false narrative, they start with so-called silent protest. After the silent protest, gradually they turn that into an agitation occupying public space. And they start blocking the roads, start in creating inconvenience for public, so it creates more negative press for government, saying that see what is happening in government today, that the public is inconvenienced. The government is not acting because they are very much afraid of what is going to be told by the media, what is going to, you know, judiciary. Judiciary has been extremely negative, as you have seen. If you were to compare in Shaheen Bagh, where they are occupying public space, the police does not have guts to go and act at all. And even now, media actually appointed so-called mediators. But if you look at what happened in 2012, Baba Ramdev was and his completely peace, no public space was occupied, but there was a lathi charge in Baba Ramdev's agitation, which was a peaceful agitation, no public was inconvenienced because it was in Ramlila Maidan. But here, where the public are inconvenienced, there is already a riot. They are using absolutely inflammatory statements. They are throwing stones at the police, but police cannot act. So that's the kind of narrative, that's the kind of situation that we have in a country where a particular community can do anything, but police and government is afraid of acting. Right? Then slowly they are using this time to build up arms. They are using this time to build up what Raj Lakhviji said, acid. If you see the news, there are containers of industrial acids were found.
Absolutely.
There were arms, there were stones that were purposely brought to be thrown from a strategic position, from terrace, etc. How did the stones go there? So there were those agitations were used to create this whole setup to then turn into violence. So the violence was pre-planned. We need to understand this. And the media has constantly played negative game. During the agitation, media was talking about freedom. How can you give freedom to the agitators on an imaginary issue that does not exist on the name of freedom of expression, but it can cause inconvenience to the thousands and thousands and thousands of residents, but no media is talking about them. And then this violence, if you look at it, IB officer was targeted. So, you know, police constable was targeted. There was a, they went after people knowing very well whom they want to kill. They picked up the target that they had planned and, you know, tortured that target and killed them. So the point we need to understand is that the government is helpless, unfortunately. Though it is supposed to be a nationalist government, but it is helpless today because probably they don't see support coming from us. When media is negative, when there is so much of negative coverage given by the opposition party, we have to stand up and raise our voice in the support of the government, and we are here to do that. And we are here to raise funds for those unfortunate people who have lost their life, thousands of people who have lost their livelihood because their shops were burned. We are here to raise funds for them. So please open your pocket. Today we need to raise funds, but we also have to use this opportunity to build a society where we are able to stand together with our government and compel our government to take a strong action against these people. Jai Hind.
Jai Hind.
I will call upon Mr. Call to please come and say a few words and share his perspective with us.
While we're changing the mic and Rakesh Kalji is getting ready, we'll show a video. I'm sure you all have seen it in
recent riot in Delhi. So I was not prepared to talk. I just wanted to come here. Having my presence was, I thought that was important. It's very heartbreaking to hear that as Krishna Reddy ji as well as Satya ji was talking about the social media. It's like it's more than Western media. Indian media is really, really trashing this major event, mostly, especially the Kerala media. They have been talking about killing and lynching the Muslim crowd there. And also they were showing in the Twitter that I was looking at a petrol pump, which was destroyed completely, and a lot of scores of bikes and everything was burnt down, and which belonged to a Hindu. And also this week, I mean 2 days ago, we were talking about the tweet that was by Bernie Sanders. He's a politician, he's contesting for the president, and then he should not be talking about the things that is not true. So they have to check the fact before they tweet like that, because it goes to millions of people. So we have tried from our side, but I think we need to work more towards it. I think the next target is Kerala. Kerala has been facing a lot of challenges. First, we had this Christian missionary. They were trying to convert people by giving freebies. Now, mostly they are targeting the Muslim. Actually, there is a huge love jihad going on. Last time when I went there, I went to a meeting, and then one of the IPS officers, he was the DIG there. I just happened to listen to his talk, and then he was talking about few girls last year. Few girls were targeted. Most of the time, probably you also have heard, two Hindu women, they were targeted. One girl was, she was missing. 21 of the people were left to Syria. One of them, the mother, the kid, used to read Bhagavad Gita, Chinmaya Mission School. She won the first prize and everything. Finally, somebody trapped her in the dental school, and she got married to a Muslim guy, and then she was pregnant. All of a sudden, she was missing. The mother was crying, bursting into tears in front of the TV cameras. But till today, they don't know where she is. Another parents, they had only one child. She was also in dental school or medical school. And she was, they tried so hard. See, look at the response that we have and they have. These parents were fighting for their daughter to come back, but one day they raised 80 lakhs rupees, one day, and they fought for her. And then probably recently you heard that, I think Kapil Sibal received 77 lakhs for the as a lawyer fee from Popular Front of India. So which was for this case that she was saying that. So just think, but these then other four or five girls who were targeted, converted. They were in the Purda. You should see that beautiful four girls. They were in Purda, and then one AVS, which is Ashvidya Samajam, they intervened and they brought them back. Now they are the volunteers, they are the advocates to help the other students, other kids who are going for that. They've been in a rental place, and you know that there is communist government in there. Everybody is targeting her, giving them so many of the legal problems. Every time they have to make sure that these, when a kid is going with some Muslim guy, nobody wants to come out and say that this has happened to their daughter. So it's very difficult for them to come out and say then for the counseling. They were talking to me about all these expenses they have, and even though we all clap and, you know, cheer them, but nobody come up to help them. They're still in a rental place. They don't have a place on their own. So, you know, we have to ask. We know that Dr. G had started RSS. Everybody say how many of the RSS people went to freedom struggle that you always hear. But there is two ways that you can. You have to always defend whatever the attacks are coming against you. At the same time, you have to make sure that you are precautious about that not to come to your way. So the freedom fighting was like, you know, onslaughts were going on for thousands of years against Hindus, but we did not do anything to prevent that. So you have to figure out what has happened to our generation, what has happened to the people. So make sure that we have to prepare the people for not to fall for this. So I think at the same time we are defending, at the same time we have to make sure that you have to come up with some measures that we don't, you know, face, we won't become the victims of this. I'm sorry I've taken too long time, but I'm sure.
Yeah. Thank you, Joshua. Without preparing, I know you can speak from heart. Now, we have till 4 o'clock. This place we have till 4 o'clock. And very, very distinguished guests are here. I'd like to invite Gauranji to come. We just have 2 minutes only. So, please, Gauranji. And then after that, Anil Sharmaji. I've been given strict instruction to keep on time. Sorry about that.
After Godhra riots, we had a similar program in fundraising. We raised funds also for the West Bengal martyrs. We means community. We raised funds for people from Kerala and Tamil Nadu. So this goes on. Most likely after some more months or years, we'll be again doing the same thing.
Yes.
Is that enough? Is that all we can do?
We should do
more. Satyaji made a very good presentation, and so did Jasnaji. It is important that we learn the history, we learn, understand the issues. Lot of WhatsApp groups are there, we are members of that. We send back and forth messages. It is like preaching to the choir. We all know the issues. We understand the situation. It doesn't do us any good just being on the WhatsApp and Twitter. We have a government in Bharat, which is not a Hindu government, which at least is not an anti-Hindu government. Time has come for us as NRIs to pressure the government to take actions. If we can put all our efforts to do How to Modi in Texas, in New York, in the West Coast. I think government owes us that much. We have here BJP president or BJP president. I believe BJP is official organization that has a link, direct connection to the government. It is their job to talk to them and let them know our anger and our frustration. It cannot go on like this forever. If, yes, development is good, I'm as pro-Modi as any person you are, but the development will be worth nothing. We are butchered in the streets like this every day. True. Delhi is not a small place, it's not West Bengal. Therefore, all I can say is that. Also, I heard somebody saying, we should. Sudan would have been gone for too long time. I've been in public life for the last 45, 50 years here. And so many times, many media committees have been formed to fight the media bias in America. Nothing has come out of it. Why? We all are very good managers at our work. We do good job at our work. Why can't we be professor about it? Why can't we few of us take it as a life mission? They won't go to any program. They will not go to Shradhanjali's. Only thing they will do is study New York Times, Washington Post, Times of India, all the rascals, and go after them. Recently, I read someplace that we should do PIL against this media here. We should. Who's going to do it? So my request to all of you is that, first of all, think about this way. In this area, the premier Hindu organizations, Vishwanda Parishad of America, HSS, Art of Living, Gayatri Parivar, BAPS, or BJP. Between them, I believe they are close to 10,000 members. And we don't even have 100 here. So that's all. The apathy is everywhere, not only in Bharat, here as well. It is this issue on which I would like us to concentrate for next 3, 4, 5 years and not worry about anything else. Thank you.
Since we are running a little bit short of time, and apparently there's another program after 4 o'clock, so Anil Sharmaji, if you can shed some views, your views.
So all of us have already talked what happened in Delhi. I'm reading a news from Agra. Days after violence broke out in Aligarh Muslim-dominated area, Babri Mandi area, posters proclaiming "Yeh ghar bikau hai" have come up outside the houses of Hindus. So how do we handle this? It's not only Delhi, right? So either we have to, like, you know, we have to, like, through BJP, we have to connect with the government and take it as a law and order situation all across the country. My wife, they had to sell their property in Ajmer because it was near the masjid, the main masjid in Ajmer, right? So all across the country, people are not feeling safe. We have a very violent minority, and majority is not ready to take on them, head-on collision. So either we have to increase some police forces in those areas, like special type of police forces, where there are, like, you know, more minority-dominated areas, use some technology, more surveillance. If you are, like, you know, if you have, like, seen, like, India was sort of like getting pushed into a civil war type of situation all across the country. We are seeing that, right? So they're getting prepared for a war type of situation. So these are, like, you know, much beyond this event. Like, you know, just by putting a Shradhanjali, it's not going to solve it. It's much, much deep rooted. And what Satyaji shared added an extra complexity how the Western powers are playing with us. So with this, I will end. Like, you know, this much, much deep rooted problem and needs to be taken at a much strategic level. Thanks.
Thank you, Anilji. Now we have Aditi ji, who has requested to speak few words. And after that, go ahead, Aditi ji. After that, we have flowers. We all will line up and offer flowers to Ratanlal ji and Ankit ji. And at the same time, we recite Shanti Mantra.
Thank you very much. Jai Bharat, Jai Bharti.
Little back, yes. Thank you.
All right. Always start something with a shloka of Gita, and I've never spoken without one. So what I remember is one from chapter 18, sarv dharman paritajya mam ekam sharanam vraja aham tvam sarv papebhyo mokshayami ma sucha. Rightly said by Krishna, but you know, there is one thing that underlies this shloka, is that you do the duty, Arjuna. I am not going to do that. I am just going to be, at the end of Gita, Shri Krishna says, do what you want to do. I have told you everything. I am not going to fight for you. And that's the whole thing that brought me to today to this point, is that we have to do something about it. I encourage each one of you to go out and make a Google search, India. You'll find somebody called Jishan Hadar writing from Guardian. You will find Tavleen Singh's son writing another article, who's been banned as being connected to the anti-India elements. But we are not doing anything. And you must think that Modi has the magic formula to do each and everything. But the problem is here in New Jersey. Problem is here in US, you are not doing anything. You are expecting Modi to have a magic wand and he will do everything. You are asking our army to fix the situation. It's not going to happen. I'll give you one instance. Just go and search Muslim NJ. You will find websites like CARE. You'll find websites which are talking about how many Muslim representatives are there. You can go ahead and search on Google. You'll find like a mayor, I don't know if I should say the name, it's Montgomery, claims to be a PhD, okay, writing anti-India one after other, like an obsessed person. It's like India is everything. She hasn't written once about what happened. 85-year-old mosque from Ahmadiyya's were taken out. She hasn't written a single word about that. Hindu girls were kidnapped and raped in Sindh almost on a daily basis. She hasn't written a single word about it. She sees a pogrom in what happened in Delhi. You and I can make the change. You and I can do the difference. As much as what we did with Sam Khan, we can do with this person as well. We have to stand up. How can you do that? I'll give you from my experience. I have written back to New York Times, and in my WhatsApp group, I shared that article with my friends, and I said, if you don't agree, this is the email address, please send a note to New York Times. You know, that article was only once, one of the three series was published, the remaining two was never published. There are websites you might want to go and check, and I'm not going to name that website, but it talks about, in name of Defense Forum, it talks about how to do Ghazwa-e-Hind. And it doesn't take much. You got to send a note to FBI and they will take care of for rest of it for you. You don't have to worry. You Google it up, NJ Muslim, and you will see 5 days back, loudspeakers are allowed in Patterson. So now, think about it. You are sleeping here and somewhere something is happening. Who is going to fix that problem? You're going to fix that problem. Come out, write to your representatives. Make sure you hit where it hurts hard, most, you know, where it hurts most. You have to make the difference. I'm here with only message that you do three things. Just to spare one day out of your week. I do that. I'm telling you, it's not a big deal. It takes a couple of hours to do that. I am asking you to do it from where you stand. If you see something around yourself, New Jersey, New York, California, US, make a difference. Unless you make a difference here, the person sitting there in Tenjanpath and in the parliament, he cannot do anything. Trust me, he won't be able to do anything. And you can do it, if no matter if you're 70-year-old or if you're 15-year-old, you can do that. You can. You have the power. So realize that power. Number two, connect people. I run a WhatsApp group where we only talk about Ram, Krishna, Shiva, everything related to religion. And my focus is very simple. I'm connecting ladies to that group. I connect one lady, one family understands that. If I'm connecting one man, sad to say, It turns mostly into a political back and forth. What Modi did versus and venting your anger. We are not venting our anger. What we are saying, we have to be strong. So connect people. WhatsApp is not the only way. You walk somewhere. Other day I was in Sai Temple and I saw somebody spitting there, washing his feet and spitting. And I asked him, like, if you are not going to keep this temple clean, do you expect somebody else to do that? The guy apologized. I want you to do that. That's the second thing I'm asking you to do. Is number one, do yourself. Number two, connect people. And number three, most important thing is what your offsprings are. They are the one who is going to be in this world tomorrow and going to pass that tradition. If your offsprings don't know what is Yajnapavit, if they don't know Gayatri Mantra, if they cannot say, if they cannot talk about Mahamrityunjay and Laghumrityunjay, I'm almost done. Laghumrityunjay, it's not a fault of those kids. It's a fault of you. I can say so because less than 5 year old, my two kids, they will, every morning they will do 5 mantra, of which one is Laghumrityunjay mantra, which is so simple anybody can do. Only 3 things. Do what you can do. That's most important. Second is connect people. And third is give your offsprings the way you want to see this world. And history, geography, everything will align to you only if you do these 3 things. Thank you very much.
Now I'd like to invite Ganeshji here. Ganeshji, please come here. And if somebody can bring that also. This one as well. We are going, we have some flowers here. So before that, I've been told to remind everyone about, there is an envelope going around, and please, your choice, whatever you do, there are these 2 websites. You can pay there, or you can write a check or a cash and give it to Ganeshji in the end. Okay, we will collect it and we'll make sure that it goes to the right place. You can trust me on that. Now, Ganeshji, do you want conclusion? So, while we are reciting mantra, if anybody else, if anybody else wants to recite mantra with us, please come here. So, Om Sahana Bhavatu, Sahana Bhunaktu, Sahaviryam Karavavahai, Tejasvinavaditamastu, Mahavidvishavahai. Om Shanti 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 Om Sarvesham Swastir Bhavatu Om Sarvesham Shantir Bhavatu Om Sarvesham Purnam Bhavatu Om Sarvesham Mangalam Bhavatu Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinah Sarve Shantu Niramayah Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu Ma Kashchit Dukbhag Bhavet Asato Ma Sadgamaya Tamso Ma Jyotir Gamaya Mrityor Ma Amritam Gamaya Kayena Vacha Manasendriyaiva Buddhyatmana Va Prakritai Swabhavat Karomi Adyad Sakalam Paraspai Narayanayeti samarpayami, Narayanayeti samarpayami, Narayanayeti samarpayami, Omkaravindu sayuktam, Nityam dhayanti yogina, Kamadam mokshadam chaiva, Omkaraya namo nama. Om Sarva Mangala Mangale Shive Sarvartha Sadike Sharanne Trambake Gauri
Narayani namostute, namo devyai mahadevyai, shivayai satatam namah, namah prakritei bhadrayai, niyatam pranatasmana. Om sharanagata dinartha paritrana parayane, sarva te hare devi, narayani namostute, om hari om.
Just one.
Om Bhadram Karnevi Shunyama Devaha Bhadram Pakshemaksha Virijatraha Stirai Rangai Sustuhas Sustanobi Vyashema Devahitam.
Naam hi nahi rahega is party ka kyunki hamara desh bat raha hai aur ye bhi nahi Majpur Brahmapuri Shivpuri Zafrabad wale ilaqon ke logon ki kahani suniye wahan log Hindu log जहां अभी प्रोफेसर कॉल ने बोला कि ये जो फैक्शनलिज्म जो होता है जब जहां ये अपना गढ़ बनाना शुरू करते हैं मैं उसके बारे में बताना चाहूंगी आपको ये गढ़ कैसे बन रहा है वहां सीमापुरी सीलमपुर ना जाने कितने इलाके हैं उन इलाकों में मुस्लिम बाहुल्य के लोग अपने घर बनाते जा रहे हैं और वहीं से हिंदू लोग कौड़ियों के दाम पर अपने घरों को बेच करके बाहर जा रहे हैं क्योंकि वो उस जगह पे नहीं रहना चाहते एक खौफ और दहशत के माहौल में जामिया मिलिया इस्लामी यूनिवर्सिटी की बात सुनिए ये सेंट्रल यूनिवर्सिटी है सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट की फंडिंग होती है मजाल है रोजे के दिनों में आप जा करके वहां लोगों के सामने खाना खा लो मजाल है आप खुलेआम खाना नहीं खा सकते अगर रोजे चल रहे हैं ये जामिया की सुप्रीमेसी है रिलीजियस सुप्रीमेसी जो कोई नहीं बताएगा हम बताएंगे क्योंकि हमने करीबी से देखा है अफसोस होता है कि हम इतने सेक्युलर हो गए कि कहीं हम सेक्युलरिज्म की भाषा ही भूल गए सेक्युलरिज्म एक हद तक सेक्युलरिज्म होता है फिर हम स्यूडो सेक्युलर हो जाते हैं आज हम ये कहना चाहें कि हम गर्व से कहना चाहें हम हिंदू हैं तो हमें कम्युनल बताया जाता है हमें टेररिस्ट बताया जाता है हिंदू रेडिकल टेररिस्ट हिंदुत्व के नाम पर हमें गाली दी जाती है बोला जाता है दीज आर द रेडिकल हिंदू टेररिस्ट अंधेरे की बात तो यह है कि पढ़े लिखे यूथ अंधेरे में खो रहे हैं इसी में हमारी यूथ जवाहरलाल नेहरू यूनिवर्सिटी जामिया मिलिया तो छोड़िए अलीगढ़ मुस्लिम यूनिवर्सिटी तो चलिए फैक्शनल हो रही है बट हमारे जो लोग जहां से आईएएस आईपीएस ऑफिसर निकला करते थे वहां गंदगी फैल रही है जहां स्यूडो सेक्युलरिज्म घर कर रहा है शर्माती हम यूथ हैं और हमारे जैसे यूथ खड़े नहीं होते वुमेन आर नॉट गेटिंग अप फ्री की टिकट लेने तो चली गई डीटीसी की लेकिन आज घर से बाहर निकल के देखें कि उनके शौहर उनके पति घर वापस आएंगे कि नहीं ये भी देख लें बच्चे घर आएंगे कि नहीं ये भी देख लें तो ये दर्द एक दिल्ली वाले पर्सपेक्टिव से बताना चाह रही हूं कि जहां 84 के दंगे भी देखे जहां वो नरसंहार हुआ और अभी नरसंहार और होगा अगर कंट्रोल नहीं किया हम सभी लोगों ने उठ करके उसका ओपनली विरोध नहीं किया अगर हिंदू ये ना बोलेंगे कि हम सेक्युलर तो हैं लेकिन आप कृपया अपनी हद में रहें जितने भी लोग रेडिकल हैं रेडिकल फैनेटिज्म काम नहीं करता है और मुस्लिम्स का ये जो रवैया है जो वो पढ़ते लिखते नहीं है मोस्टली जो विमेन जहां बैठी है शाहीन बाग में पढ़ी लिखी नहीं है उनको जो डराया जा रहा है गलत इंफॉर्मेशन देके उनको कोई बताने वाला नहीं है सच क्या है तो ये सब चीजें बताने का हमारा टाइम आया है कि हम पहले तो अपने ही स्यूडो सेक्युलर लोगों को जगा दें थोड़े प्रेस्टिट्यूट्स को कंट्रोल कर दें सो कॉल्ड उसके बाद में कुछ एक्शन होगा दिल्ली में जगने के लिए प्रोफेसर कॉल का बहुत अच्छा प्रपोजल है कि उस स्कूल को मजबूत बनाया जाए अगले एक हफ्ते में पूरी डोनेशन और सपोर्ट के साथ में कार सेवक भेजे जाए रादर और वहां पर स्कूल को दोबारा खड़ा किया जाए तो शायद हमारी मजबूती नजर आएगी तो मैं इतना ही कहूंगी कि देश बट रहा है क्योंकि हम ढील दे रहे हैं ढील उतनी दीजिए जितने में हम पतंग को उड़ा सके कट गई तो दोबारा नहीं आएगी ये हमारे देश की धरती है ये हमारे को बचानी है और उसके लिए हमें कर्मबद्ध रहना है थैंक यू जय हिंद
जय हिंद भारत माता की यस दिस इज अ फाइट अगेंस्ट अ सर्टेन ग्रुप ऑफ पीपल देयर थॉट प्रोसेस इज टू रिमूव एनीवन हु डजंट लुक लाइक यू हु डजंट बिलीव इन व्हाट यू बिलीव एंड इट इज वर्ल्ड वाइड नाउ आईड लाइक टू इनवाइट कृष्णा रेड्डी जी and he's going to shed some light on this Delhi terror attack and how it started and where we are now. Krishna Reddy ji.
भारत माता की
जय।
भारत माता की
जय।
Today it's a sad day. My sincere condolences to the fallen officers Ratan Lal ji and Ankit Sharma ji and other victims of Delhi riots. We are pained by these incidents. I'm going to focus more on media, what they've been doing in this country and what we should do here. As you know, the roots of the cause is obviously CIA, Citizenship Amendment Act. And they wanted to show the world that, you know, India is taking rights away from the minorities. That is the narrative that they've created. That's the narrative that was prevailed in this, you know, in this Western world. I mean, you look at it, you know, especially Europe or the United States, the people are asking that why are you taking the citizenship away from minorities? But this has nothing to do with the CIA, has nothing to do with it. But the narrative that they've created, that is going on in this country. So that's one thing. And I'm just going to refer one article, recent article. And you know how the Western media has been, distorting the facts, especially about the Delhi riots. There was an article in New York Times written by Jeffrey Gettleman, Suhasini Raj, and Samir Yasir. There was a picture shown in New York Times. It says, Hindus beat a Muslim man during the clashes in New Delhi. That's not the fact. They completely ignored the other facts of the whole riots. I mean, the officers died. They did not talk about the officers in that article. They did not talk about who orchestrated, who engineered these articles, the riots. But they just put the heading, a photo. It shows that Hindus beat a Muslim man. So these are the articles read by the local lawmakers here, Bernie Sanders like, or the people here, congressmen. I mean, they read all these articles and come up with the impression, come up with these ideas that, oh, there's something happening against minorities, but which is not true. So we have to tackle. I mean, I know that the funding is coming from a billionaire and a lot of organizations. They are trying to, create this narrative against India to malign BJP government and India. So what can we do here? I think from here, I know BJP and a lot of, Indians, our brothers and sisters will take care of what's happening in India. But what can we do here in this country? That's also very important for us here. Because we live here, our children live here, so we need to focus here in this country. We need to, start from the grassroots level. Obviously, we should talk to our local leaders. You know, either a local mayor or local, even the school boards or everywhere, wherever we go, and at least we start talking about these, that, whatever the perception that is completely wrong. And then go to the next level, congressmen, and also these presidential candidates. There are many ways to reach out to them. Either tweeting is a more effective way of doing it. Either you have to follow them and then retweet them with the comments. And the other one is emailing them. I mean, we have email addresses and also making phone calls. So we have to reach out to them that, they should know that there are some people who are concerned about their views, concerned about their lies. So we have to be proactive. We have to do, each one of us should have a Twitter account and then start tweeting them, start emailing them. Then only at least they see the other side of the facts. I mean, press releases are good. I mean, you can have a press release from India, press release and making statements are good. But when they see these statements or see these messages from the grassroots level people, then only they'll listen. So we got to start working on that and then focus on social media and then try to tell them that the facts are different from what they know. And you know, we have to be, you know, it's not an easy task, but we have to start doing this. Every one of us can you know, do this. Om Shant.
Thanks, Aram. Now, our firebrand, Satya Dosapati ji, is going to give a presentation. So, and as he gives his presentation about the Delhi terror attacks, I will use the word terror attacks, and he's going to discuss as well what led to it. And why?
You
want to use that one? Is better. While Satyaji is preparing his PowerPoint presentation, I see Ramon Sharmaji in the audience, Anil Joshiji, many are here, and we would like to invite people in the audience if they have a few words that. The passion, the anguish that they have.
छोटा सा संदेश न्यू जर्सी की तरफ से दिल्ली के लोगों के लिए हिंदुस्तान के लिए मजबूती देने के लिए We are right there in spirit with our brother there in Delhi. This is a message from New Jersey here. From Mia Mata Temple, I live here today, where we are having this Shradhanjali Sabha, as well as a fundraising event, where we are Delhi ke victims ke liye fundraising kar rahe hain, jo ki un sabhi bhaiyon ko di jayegi. देश को टूटने नहीं देना और
So, music, no music. Rajashmi. No music.
Study. Hey, Dev.
I mean, madam. One person.